Shelly shared with me. That song represents the way she felt when Leon was just always beside her when she went through her illness. So, sorry, this kind of touching for me. Welcome. Thank you for coming to celebrate the life of Leon Russell. We're all very privileged to know him, and we're certainly going to come as one together here today. I'm going to read the eulogy. It says, Leon was preceded in death by his parents, his first wife, Gail, brother Dennis, Donnie, and sister Jean. The survivors are Leon, his wife, Shelly, three sons, Brady Russell, wife Lindsay, Brandon Russell, wife Melissa, and Matt Sophia. One daughter, Bree Fenton, and her husband, David. Two sisters, Joyce Cicero and Mona Moore. Six grandchildren, Kylie Fenton, Michaela Fenton, and McKendall Fenton, Nikki Russell, Evelyn Russell, and Gabe Kempe. Leon was 70 years old, and he passed away on February 9th. He was born June 26, 1948 in Blanchard, Oklahoma, to Leola and Wyman Russell. He served in the U.S. Air Force and enjoyed racing cars. He was preceded in death by his parents, his first wife, Gail, brother Donnie, and sister Jean. Leon is survived by his wife, Shelley, three sons, Brady Russell, and wife, as mentioned before. And so at this point, I'd like to say a quick prayer, and then we'll proceed. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, O Lord, for all your many blessings. We just come to you and thank you for the life of Leon. Lord, we just ask that you will forever remain in our memories and in our hearts. You will comfort him as he joins you. Lord, that you would just give us the strength to live each day with love and a smile as you carry around so many times. And Lord, we thank you for this time together as we honor him and celebrate his life. In Jesus' precious name we pray. So, at this point, if there's anyone that has a memory or something you want to share about Leon, I would invite you to come. I will start, though, with my own. And it's just the love and the smiles that Leon always had when we would be racing. I mean, if he went out, man, he was ready to watch and just enjoy the whole event always. And always such a pleasure to be around. So I'm grateful for that. And John Wilson, who wasn't able to be here today, he had sent me a memory of his. He said that when Pam was starting chemotherapy, that Leon came over to them and said, just want you to know everything will work out. And if you ever need to talk, just let me know. He said that meant so much to him. And, you know, it's something when you identify with someone that's going through something. And so it's such a comfort. So anyone has something that they would like to share, and please, you all share everything that you have. That's the reason we're here, is to celebrate this life. Bill, come on up here, and that way everybody can hear you.
I'm Bill Boone, and I'm one of the board members of the Texas Muscle Car Club Challenge Series that Leon was a member of, along with And we just want to give our heartfelt condolences to the Russell family. We really care about Leon. I remember the first time I met him, he came up and shook my hand, smiled at me. He's a Ford guy, I'm a Mopar guy. But he was there, always talking to people, shaking hands. When they won, or when they run it up, or when they did something good, he came over for gratitude. And that was an important thing. He was always that way. I know we're all going to miss him. He was part of the Muscle Car Series, and we really appreciate that. We know that the Lord has a plan for him, and we thank the Lord for giving us this time with him.
Does anybody else have some words they'd like to share? Thank you. Come on.
Hello, I have known Ray for 20 years, been my best friend. Long time. Leon was just a real nice person. He actually gave me my first car. It was a 1987 Crown Vic, two-door. Rusted over, and he called it Hootie. He said, "Zach, you come get this car. You can have it." And Hootie was, I think she was originally maroon, but she was mostly rusted over by the time I got her. But she had a 5.0 V8 that ran. So I just want to say he was always the nicest guy. And every time I went over there for dinner, "Zach, come on up late." "No, Leon, I'm good. I had dinner at home." He goes, "Zach, you probably need to get up late." And he would not stop until I had three servings. So if I get the diabetes, y'all know it's Leon's fault. Go miss that man and love him a lot.
Thank y'all all for coming and doing that. We're going to see a video now that will help us dig deeper into the Leon.
Go everywhere.